الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله كل الأرض وسوين تعرفة تفرجه من لدي أف عرفة In the day of happiness, in the day that everyone will release from his sins that he may fall in it. This is the day of forgiveness. This is the day of peace. This is the day of mercy. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده وعبد الله مخلصًا له الدين حتى أتاه من ربه اليقين فصلى الله على سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا إلى الله محمد وقف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من لدي وف عرفة The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the day of Arafah, he stand and call all the mankind. His speech is not only for the believers, his speech is for all mankind. Because he said, أيها الناس, إن ربكم واحد وإن أباكم واحد. All people, your Lord is one and your Father is one. This is the message of unity of the people. This is the message of mercy. The message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it for Muslims and for all people in this world. Because Islam is for all people and the Quran is for all mankind. The Quran is the message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the mankind. And the Quran included all the messages that it came before. And we as a Muslims, we love all the prophets of Allah. And we do following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he is the final messenger of Allah azza wa jal and he is the seal of the prophets of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stand over Arafah in Hajjatul Wada' and he gives the message for all mankind. The message of human right, the message of human right for all people. And he said, إِنَّ دِمَاكُمْ وَأَمْوَالَكُمْ وَأَعْرَاضَكُمْ حَرَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ كَحُرْمَةِ يَوْمِكُمْ هَذَا فِي بَلَدِكُمْ هَذَا فِي شَهْرِكُمْ هَذَا This is the message of human right. 1400 years ago, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the people that this is the message of the Quran. The soul of a human being protected by Allah. The money of the human being protected by Allah. The dignity of the people protected by Allah. And this is the message of Islam. Islam is to keep the life of people and to keep them, protect the money of people and protect the dignity of people. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر This is the day when Ibrahim عليه السلام he won in the test of Allah سبحانه وتعالى he won when he followed the guidance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى and his son Ismail also won in this test that Allah سبحانه وتعالى when he ordered him وقال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى. قال يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. The father in this says, and the son in his says, and we have to follow the way that Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam look for the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to win in our life and to win in our hereafter. And this is the holiday of Muslims. The holiday of Muslims represent obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Eid al-Fitr represent the fasting of the month of Ramadan. And Eid al-Adha represent the obedience to Allah azza wa jal. How Ibrahim and Ismail and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The guidance of Allah azza wa jal is the best in this life to follow it. Allah order us to pray the five times and the Jum'an we pray. Allah order us to fast the month of Ramadan and we fast. Allah order us to pay the zakat and we will do. And Allah azza wa jal order us to do a pilgrimage, a Hajj to Mecca, and the Muslim doing that. This is the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill our deen and complete our deen. And this verse revealed to the Prophet in the day of Arafah, Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa radhitu lakum al-Islam deena. Brothers and sisters, we have to know that we have five obligations. We have to look for it seriously. The first one, our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah has a right on us and we have to deal with Allah in serious issue, in serious issue. Allah azza wa jal, our health in his hand, our sickness in his hand, our success in his hand, our fail in his hand, our life in his hand, our death in his hand, our soul, the solution that all the Muslims face nowadays in his hand. The solution what the Muslim facing a day in the hand of Allah Azza wa Jal, not in the hand of those who own the money, not in the hands for those who own the power, not in the hands for those who dominate other people by no right. It is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Building the relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will solve all our problems, whether it is an individual problems, our family problems, or a society problems, or a mankind problems. This is the first obligation. Build the relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number two, we have another obligation toward ourselves. We have to do with ourselves to raise the raise the iman and our level of iman in the eye of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والله عز وجل قد دعانا في كتابه الكريم حيث قال وابتغ فيما آتاك الله الدار الآخرة ولا تنس نصيبك من الدنيا. النفس أيها الإخوة, our soul, if we do not guide it, it will guide us. And as the statement say, النفس كالسيف إن لم تقطعها قطعت. The soul is like the sword. If you do not use it in the proper way, then you will be affected. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us the last verse in the Quran, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. Feel Allah and observe Him that everyone of us is going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as we come to pray Eid and we are going to leave this hall. No one will stay forever in this hall. The same times we come to this life and we are going to leave this life sooner or later. And we have to prepare for the moment that every one of us will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He going to ask us about our life, about our knowledge, about our money, about our family, about our Islam. What did we do for all of this? Then the final message for the people in the day of judgment. There is two houses only, the paradise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for those who do their duty in this life. And Allah explained our Jannah. He said, مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون فيها أنهار من ماء غير آس وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين وأنهار من عسل مصفى ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات ومغفرة من ربهم. Other house that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for those who disobey and turn away from the message of Allah Azza wa Jal. قال عز من قائل كمن هو خالد في النار وسقوا ماء حميما فقطع أمعاءهم. أيها الإخوة, we have to take care of our nafs. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَأَمَّا حَقُّ نَفْسِكَ عَلَيْكَ فَأَنْ تَسْتَعْمِلَهَا بِطَاعَةِ اللَّهِ. The right of your nafs on you, to use your nafs and to use your body by the obedience of Allah عز وجل. فتؤدي إلى لسانك حقه وإلى سمعك حقه وإلى بصرك حقه وإلى يدك حقها وإلى رجلك حقها وإلى بطنك حقه وإلى فرجك حقه وتستعين بالله بعد ذلك. من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليحفظ الرأس وما وعى والبطن وما حوى وليذكر الموت والبلى. وأما الواجب الثالث أيها الإخوة, our third duty is to our the duty to our family. We are responsible in front of Allah Azza wa Jal about our family. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara wa qudha an-nas wal hijara alayha malaikatun ghilaz shidad la ya'sun Allah ma amarahum wa yaf'alun ma yu'marun. The duty to our family, brothers and sisters, is to guide our family to Allah Azza wa Jal, to strengthen the relation of our family with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Leave the prayer at home so your kids will see you that you will pray to Allah Azza wa Jal. Have a weekly meeting in the house with your wife and with your kids. Sit down and read the Quran, read the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are in charge of your family in the day of judgment. Treat your wife as the best. Allah Azza wa Jal said in the Quran, وَعَاشِرُوهُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. أيها الإخوة, the fourth obligatory for us and we have to take care of is our society. We are a part of our society that we have to do our best to guide our society to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to call for good and forbid bad. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إلا قرآن، وما كان ربك ليهلك القرى بظلم وأهلها مصلحون. الله is not going to destroy the countries if the people in that countries call for Allah Azza wa Jal and try to follow the guidance of Allah Azza wa Jal. And our last obligatory to our nation, we are a part of a Muslim nation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our nation as the best nation that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in our shoulder the message that we have to carry it and to give it to the mankind. And what we face nowadays, it is an problem that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned it in the hadith, ستكون فتن القاعد فيها خير من القائم والقائم فيها خير من الماشي والماشي فيها خير من الساعي من تشرف لها تستشرفه فمن وجد منها ملجأ أو معاذا فليعذ به. صدق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We'll sit down and come for the second khutbah inshallah. That is very short. الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات المسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر للحاج ولمن استغفر له الحاج. اللهم حبب لفتياتنا الحجاب وحصن شبابنا من الفاحشة يا أرحم الراحمين واجعلنا هداة مهتدين يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اهد أهل أمريكا إلى صراطك المستقيم يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وكل عام وأنتم بخير والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.